Hi guys, so it's been a while since I've uploaded videos related to DV tutorials, and now it's back. Okay, so one of my friends want me to create a sales page for her website. So the website is super simple. She is very consistent with the design that she wants. You want this kind of bubble thing, and there is some bracket. So I just follow her design and implement it on her website. So in this area, she wants to have like an icon beside the text, and this is not available in DV. So I'm gonna give you like a quick walkthrough how to make that work. So this is applicable on tab modules, and you can also use that on accordion, and also I believe you can also use that on toggle. Okay, but now we will start with the I'm gonna give you the tutorial for the tab first, but basically the code that we will use are both the same. So first is you need to prepare your icon. So this is the icon for the media, and I'm going to resize that one because I mean this is just an icon, so we don't need a higher resolution of our icon. So I'm gonna resize that into 20, maybe 30. By the way, I would recommend you use SVG, but for the purpose of this presentation, let's just keep it PNG, which is the common extension for an image. So digital marketing icon. Okay, we already have the smaller version of our digital marketing icon. Now it's time. Okay, I'm gonna. Okay, I have some. Okay, it's time to upload that picture. So let's go back to the media, and then let's upload that icon that we did here. And now let's go click this gear icon and go to the tab, and then go to the custom and custom CSS, and then go if you want it to be like in before, the image, the icon will go here. And if you want it to be after the text, then you need to put it in the after. And I wanted to put it in the after, I mean the text and then the icon. So we will use after instead of before. So I'm gonna put content and then an empty string and then semicolon and then background URL. And then we will put a okay, so I'm gonna grab that one and put the text on here, and yeah, so this part, and then I will put like a width, is it a background? So I'm gonna put a width, and then background repeat should be no repeat, and by the way it should be a background image, and then I will remove this one because I want the URL super shorter as possible. So let's put like a width of 20px, and I want to put a position of absolute and height of 20px. So as you can see here, you'll see that the icons is showing already. Now I want to put like a margin left of -1 rem, or let's make it -1.2. I think we can go to 1.5, and then we will add another, I think padding right would be good. So we have that already. Now we will go to the text, and this is 30 pixel by 30 pixels. I'm going to use 30 instead. So we have that. So as you can see, it is already it is already working. I mean, the design that we want working is already popping out, but we want to extend that horizontal line, that vertical line in here. So I'm going to save that first, and then let's save it. And then okay, let's exit the visual builder, and I will try to move that text in there. So I'll put like, let me inspect that one. So there is a padding here called padding 4px, and the left and right is 40px. So I'm gonna extend that into 50. So let's see. So yeah, so 50px will be perfect. Now I'm gonna grab this code, I'll put it in a notepad, and then we will adjust this margin thing here. Okay, now I'm gonna so we will adjust the margin thing there, but first let me just put a custom CSS class name so we can target these tabs. But if you don't, I mean, reason why I want to use a class, because I want to isolate the changes in this certain module only, so it will not affect on other modules. Let's say, for example, you will create another tab and you don't want to have an icon on it. So instead of targeting the general module class, you need to create a unique class name or unique ID for that certain module in order for you to isolate the changes in that specific module. Yeah, I hope that makes sense. Let me know if you're confused. But yeah, so I'm gonna put let's put a class called tab with icons or tab icons. And then I'm going to go to the, let's go back to the theme options, and then let's go with the custom CSS. By the way, you can use a child theme and put it in your style.css. So, but we don't have, if you have a lot of, you know, you have a lot of customization on your, in your WordPress website, then you can definitely use that one. So, I mean, put the CSS codes into your child theme style.css. So we will put that, and I'm going to replace this, because the original syntax is 40px, right? So we want it to be, I want it to be 50, or maybe I think let's just use 4px, and then I want it to be 50px. There, I want to keep the left into 40px, but I want the right padding has a 60px padding. So let's save that one. Let's see how it looks now. So I'm going to exit this, and okay, it's not reflecting. Let's see why it's not reflecting. So I'm going to search this class name that I just created, and Control F for the dev tools, and let's search this one. So as you can see here, okay, let me just rub it back. Okay, and now I'm gonna copy this one, and let's see that this is, where is the 30px? So li, let me just see this one. Okay, so I'm going to put another 70 here. Let's see if there is a changes. Okay, my bad, it should be 40 here and then 70 here. So let's see. Yeah, so this is perfect already. I'm gonna grab this code and put it here, and let's save that one. Now we have enough space in here. Now we can change the margin left into the icons to move these icons in this part. So let's enable the visual builder again, and then I will click the gear icon, advanced, and this margin left, I want that to be 3. Would that work? Yeah, I think it's perfect. So 3, and it's cool. Now I'm going to replicate the code on the advanced part and put it on the other tabs like management and metrics. So click custom. By the way, if you want it to be in the you want it to put in this part, you can use before. But as you can see here, like, this is the style. It duplicates in this part because we move the padding, we adjust the default padding in there. So So if you click this one and then put it in the after, you'll see that the changes. So let's keep it duplicate and let's change the icons later. So we already have that one, and then let's save that. Now I'm going to look for the management icon, which is marketing management. So let's look for the marketing management. This is the marketing management, and I will, let's save that one, and then I will adjust the size into 30px. By the way, I would recommend you use SVG so you can manipulate the designs. Like if you can change the color without, you know, re-uploading the image itself, because the PNG is a static color. So yeah, let me know if you want me to create a tutorial on that. But this one is super basic, so I don't want to be, I will not use that SVG thing. So click the management and the custom, and then I will change this text in here and put it there. And now let's go back to the metrics. It should be statics. So this is the icon for the statics, for the metrics. And let's change that again into 30px. So 30px, saved. Go back again to the media and copy. And is this the matrix? No, this is the statistics. Now I'll go back to the tab, click the gear, advanced, custom CSS, and change the background image source. So we already have an icon on our tabs. Now this will work on accordion and in the accordion and the other module. So this will work on the accordion module. So if I grab this one, okay, let me just click this. Okay, copy. This is the default icon for the accordion, but if you paste the code that we just created and go put it in the after side, I think it's in before, I'm sorry. So in before, you'll see that it is pointing on here for the before. But if you want to change this one, I believe you can just go to the icons, this one. So you need to put it on the icons part, and yeah. You can see here it's changing. If you want to put it like in the default, you can remove the margin left thing. No, not margin left, but you can remove this code so it goes here in this part. So that's how the accordion works. Now let's go to the other module called it's Toggle. So Toggle has the same style. So if you just go to the custom CSS, Toggle, look for the Toggle icon, and boom. So we're good to go. Yeah, I hope this has been helpful, guys. Let me know if you find this valuable. Comment down below if you have other tutorials you want me to do on DV, let me know. Just randomly leave a comment on my YouTube channel or send me a private message on Facebook. So yeah, I also create some this kind of design for her. Like she's super specific of what the design she want on the sales page. Like I just want to have a bracket and some subheadings there and has a bubble in it. So yeah, so everything can be actually customized using DV. So but it needs some custom CSS and maybe JavaScript if you really want to follow a specific designs on your website. So yeah, again, hope you subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos related to DV. So if you click the subscribe button this below this video, it means that you want to see videos related to web design and DV. That will notify me that I need to create designs related to DV. As you can see, some of my videos here are random. So sometimes I create designs about Learn World. Sometimes it's just super personal, like how did I grow my YouTube channel? Because that is like the on-demand request. So if you want me to create tutorials or instructions on how you can customize your Divi website, then make sure that you hit this, okay, let's say for example, this one, custom CSS. So make sure you hit the subscribe in here. I cannot see it because I am logged in, but if I use incognito here,
hi guys,
make sure you click the subscribe there, because I can see that, oh, some of my subscribers really want to let me create tutorials related to Divi. So thank you so much again. Have a great day.